Once again, good morning, friends. So I welcome you all to my Java class. And today we are going to see about arrays in Java. So previously we have seen strings in Java and how we handle strings in Java. So let us today we see arrays in Java. So these are the topics which we are going to see today. So introduction to array in Java and how to create, initialize, and accessing the Java. An array of objects, what is multidimensional array, and how they are created, and then passing array to the methods, returning array from the methods, and cloning of the array. So these are the various topics we are going to see today. So let us begin with the introduction. So what is an array? An array is a group of variables that are referred by a common name. So this is a collection of variables of a same data type. So, but it is a little bit different when compared to C and C++ in Java, because the arrays are considered as an object. Entirely, it is different from C and C++. So these are the some features of array. In Java, all arrays are dynamically allocated. So here the arrays are allocated dynamically. And arrays are, since arrays are object in Java, we can find their length by using their member length. So in by using the array class, we have a length member, and with this using length member, we can find the length of an array. Whereas in C, C++, we'll be using of size of. Here we use the length member. And next one is a Java array variable can also be declared like other variable with a square bracket with the data types. We'll be seeing the syntax, how we create an array. In that, we'll be using a square bracket for the array. A array variable variable in an array are ordered and each have an index beginning from zero. So here also we have a index values which is being beginning from zero. An array can be also used as a static variable, local variable, and a method of parameters. So you can pass the array as a parameter in methods and be considered as a local variable and a static field. The size of an array must be specified by an int value, not with a long or short. So here we'll be assigning a size of an array by using a int values. And the direct superclass of array type is object. So object is a direct superclass of your array. So let's see how to create initialize and accessing an array. So first, there are two types of arrays. One is one-dimensional array and multidimensional array. So let's begin with the one-dimensional array. So then one-dimensional array, the general syntax for creating the array is, here's the type var name with a square bracket, or you can place this square bracket in the type square bracket var name. So these are the two type of syntax for creating an one dimensional array. So here in your declaration of an array, you have two components. One is type and var name. Here this type is nothing but the type of your data type. So what array is going to contain, what type of data it is going to contain, that is the type. So the element type determines the data type of each element that comprises the array. Like array of int type, we can also create an array of other primitive data types. Here you can also create other primitive data types array. So like char, float, double, etc. And use a different data type also, like objects of a class. And thus the element type for each array determines what type of data the array will be hold. So what type of data the array is going to hold, that is the type of an array. And second component, var name. Var name is nothing but the user defined name given to the variable. Okay, that is the array name. So here is an example for int data, int variable, int array of square bracket. You can replace the square bracket in near the type. So int square bracket of int array. So this is the syntax for declaring an array. So you can also declare an array of different data types: byte, short, boolean, long, float, double, and char. So you can also create like this primitive data types array, and also user defined data types like object of class. So my class array of. So this is the object array of my class. So the superclass is object. So you can create an object for that object array of your class object, and for collection also array of collections of unknown type. For unknown type also you can create an array. So these are the declaration of arrays of different data types. And once if you declare an array, the memory will not be assigned to the array. So if you want to allocate a memory size, you have to instantiate your array. For instantiation, we use a new keyword. So let us see how we allocate a memory for an array. So in previous step, you have declared an array, which only it tells an array has been created, but the memory will not be allocated for that array. So for allocating a memory, we have to instantiate. So instantiate, we have to use a new keyword like this. The syntax for the instantiation of an array is, or installation of an array is here, where name is equal to new, type of, and size. So while you're initializing an array, you have to specify the type and the size of your array. So here the type specifies the type of the data being allocated, and size specifies the number of element in an array. And var name is the name of array variable that is linked to the array. So this is a var name, is a variable which you declared, and by using a keyword you have to specify the type, which type of data you are going to store, and what is the size of the arrays. The size indicates the size. So here's an example for the installation. So first I declare an array int array of square bracket. So this is a declaration statement, and after declaration, this does not allocate memory. For allocating a memory, we have to write the second installation. Int array is equal to new int of 20. So this initializes the array by allocating a memory of 20 size. So this is the memory allocation to the array. So this two statement can be written in a single statement. So int square bracket int array is equal to new int of type 20. So this is the combining both the statement in the previous line. So this is simple syntax. And next one is array literal. So once you know what is the data you are going to store in array and size of the array, then we can use an array literal. So here is a syntax for array literal. So int square bracket int array is equal to new int of the values which you want to store in the array. So this is a declaring array literals. So this is how you declare a or define a variables in your array. So in the length of an array determines the length of the created array. So here I didn't specify the array size. So the array size will be allocated based on your number of variables you assign. So here I have 10 variables, 1 to 10, I have been stored in this int array. So the array size will be allocated for as 10. So this is how the memory will be allocated for this array literal. And the new statement, this is the simplest form of writing the previous statement. In your latest version of Java, there is no need of writing this new int of square bracket. This statement, this does not need it. So this is the simplest method, int of square bracket, int array is equal to the variables which you want to store in your array. So this is the simplest, simple syntax in latest version Java. So there is no need of writing int new keyword and int of square bracket, type and this square bracket. It's not needed. So once you are declared and initialized the array, you want to access it. So for accessing an array, we have to need a looping statement. So we'll be using a for loop statement for accessing the array. So let us see how to access an array by using a for loop. Each element in array is accessed via its index value. By using an index value only, we'll be accessing the array values. So if you want to access a value of an array, you need a index value. So the index value begins with 0 and ends at the total array size minus 1. So if your array is of 20 size, then the index value starts from 0 to 19. So if the array size is 5, the value will be 0 to 4. So the index value begins from 0 to the array values, array size minus 1. All the element of array can be accessed using a Java for loop. So Java for loop is used for accessing an array. Here is a simple syntax. So for loop, you have created a for loop with a counter variable I, and you are checking the condition array.length. This array.length is nothing but it specifies the max your length of an array. So this loop executes until it reaches the end of an array. So this statement will print all the variables. So system.out.println is to print your element. And element dot index I, when your loop execute first time, the I value will be 0. The element at index 0 is equal to array of 0. So array of 0 is nothing but the starting variable of your array. It will be printed. So likewise, all the variables will be printed by using this for statement. So let us see an example. So here is an example for accessing an array by using for loop. So in my main class, I have created an array. At first, I declared an array of int of array, and then I have initialized an array of size 5. And now I am initializing their values. So after allocating a memory, I am initializing the values. Array of 0 is equal to 10. Array of 1 is equal to 20. And similarly, a 2, 3. Array of 2, 3, 4 is equal to 30, 40, 50. So now I have declared an array and allocated a memory of 5. And now initialize the value for 5 variables. Now by using the for statement, just I created a for statement. Int I is equal to 0. I less than array dot length. Now the array dot length is 5. So the size of your array. And then increment I plus plus. Inside the for loop, just I am printing the statement. So this statement will print the first element of I 0. A of array of 0, 10, and then again the second iteration, it will print array of 1, array of 2, array of 3, and array of 4 respectively. So let us see the output of this program. So here is an output. So element at index 0 is equal to 10, 1 is equal to 20, 4, 2 is equal to 30, 3 is equal to 40, 4, 50. So this is how we access an array by using a for loop. So this is a simple example for accessing an array. And next, let us see array of objects. So next, array of objects. An array of objects is created just like an array of primitive data type items in the following way. Here we have a student, a user-defined class called student. For that, I have created an array object, ARR, is called new array student of 7. This creates a memory space for 7 student objects. And 7 student object can be stored in this array. A student object have to be instantiated using a constructor of a student class, and their reference should be assigned to the array element in the following ways. So here is an example. Let us see an example for array of objects. So this is my class array of object. In that class, I have created a student, declare a student array of integer array, and allocated memory for 5 students. I have 5 students I have been created, allocated a memory, and now I am initializing a value for each object. Array of 0 is equal to new student of 1, 20, and this will call the your constructor function. Here is your constructor function student, which will assign the member's role number and name for your member variables of the student class whenever object is instantiated. So this will initialize the value for your first student. Similarly, array of 1, second student, 2, 3, 4 for respective students. By using a for loop, we can print the array of objects. So let us see the output of this program. So here is an output of the program where the element of at 0 is equal to 1, comma Ram. Element at 1 is to Karthik. At 2, 3, Kumar. Element at 3, 4, Vijay. At element at 4, 5, Nikhil. So these are the values of each object. So this is how we create array of objects and print the values. And next, suppose if the user is trying to access the array index value which is above the array size. So there are 3 conditions. If your user is trying to access a value less than the 0, index value is less than 0 or greater than 0 or equal to the size, then when the JVM throws an array index out of bound exception to indicate that array has been accessed with the illegal index. So these are the 3 illegal index values. If your value is less than 0, if your value is greater than the array size or equal to the array size. If 3 negative illegal values is given, then the array index out of bound exception will be occurred. The JVM will be thrown. For example, let us see this example. In my array class, in my main method, I created an array with a size of 2. And I assign a value for that array. Array of 0 is equal to 10, array of 1 is equal to 20. So my array size is 2 and I have 2 values in my array. In a for loop, I have given a condition here equal to, less than or equal to. That means if I is equal to array length, that means when this loop executes first time, the I value is 0, the condition true and it goes to the statement system .out.println, a of 0 is equal to 10, the output 10 will be printed. In second iteration, the I value is 1 and the condition is true, the system will print I of array of 1, the output is 20. And in third iteration, this I value will be 2 and again it checks the condition 2 equal, less than or equal to array length. Array length is 2. So this again the condition is true and it prints the statement array of 2. Where array of 2 is not available because array size is our index value is 0 to 1 only. But array index of 2 is greater than the index value. So then it shows an exception error. So exception in thread main, java.lan.array index out of bound exception. So this is an exception error which you are accessing these illegal index value. So this is the exception occurred while using an array. Now let us see multi-dimensional array. So multi-dimensional array are arrays of array which each element of an array holding the reference of one other array. So here these type of arrays are called as a jacked array. For example, let us see this image here that if your array each element is referring a subarray. So this is called array of array. So that is the definition tells multi-dimensional array are arrays of array with each element of array holding the reference of another array. It is holding the reference of another array. So these are also known as a jacked array. A multi-dimensional array is created by appending one set of square bracket per dimension. So for a single dimensional array, we have one set of square bracket. If you are mentioning a two-dimensional array, let us see here the syntax. We have two pair of square brackets, int, square bracket, int array is equal to new int of, that is specify the size of 2. 10 and 20 rows and columns. So similarly for three dimensional, we have three set of square brackets and three sizes. So this is how we declare the multi-dimensional array. So let us see an example. So here is an example in multi-dimensional array. In my main method, I have declaring and initializing a 2D array. Here int array of square the two square brackets pass is equal to the values. So here the 2, 7, 8, 9 is some kind of rows and columns representation. So when this data will be like this 2, 7, 9, 3, 6, 1, 7, 4, 1. So the 2 represents the index value of 0, 0. 7 indicates a value of 0, 1, 0, 2, 9. 3 represents 1, 0. 6 represents 1, 1, and 1 represents 1, 2. Similarly, 7 represents 2, 0, 4 represents 2, 1, and 2 represents 2, 2. So this is the values of I and j. So whereas in single dimensional array, when you access an array, you use a for loop statement. Similarly, here also we use a for loop statement for accessing the array values. But as it is a two-dimensional array, we have to use a two for loop statements to access the array. Here for say example, we are having a two array index index values. Two index values are there for this array. So first I indicates the first index value and j indicates the second index value. So array of i and j. So when this loop executes, first I value will be 0 and j value will be 0. Array of 0, 0, the 2 will be identified. And second, this loop again executes. In this iteration, the second iteration, that this loop again executes, the j value will be incremented and again the 0, 1, the 7 will be printed. Again this iteration j will be 2, 0, 2, 9 will be printed. So similarly the all the values will be printed and the output will be 2, 7, 9, 3, 6, 1, 7, 4, 2. So this is a pictorial representation of a multi-dimensional array. So each array representing another subarray. So this is called array of array. So this is how the multi-dimensional arrays are handled. So this is for mainly using a matrix or some other data to be stored in the form of rows and columns. And next we see how the passing and how to pass an array to a methods. So similar to the variables, the array can also be passed to the methods. So let us see with an example. Here is an example, a class test. In that main method, I have created an array of 3, 1, 2, 5, 6, 4. So this is my array. So I can pass this array in a method called sum. So this sum method, I am passing the array. So array as a parameter. So this sum method, just accessing having an array as a parameter, just checking in the for loop, you are adding each element of the array and returning and printing the value of that sum. So sum will be printing the addition of all the variables in the array. So here is how we pass a value array as a parameter with the method. So passing array to the method sum. So this is a simple example for passing the array to the method. Likewise, we can also return an array from the method. So like passing an array, we can also return an array from the method. So for this, have a simple example. In this, I have created an array, int array of array. An array value is assigned by calling a function m1. So I am calling a function m1, which is returning a integer value, integer array 1, 2, 3. So new int of 1, 2, 3. This will be returned to this statement. So this is how we return a value array. I've written an array to the function call. So previous method we have been passing the array as a parameter. In this example, I am returning a value as a in array. So here new int of 1, 2. This array is passed by using a return statement to the function call. So here the array will be assigned with this 1, 2, 3 value, and you can print and see the output by using a print system.out.println statement. So this is how we pass the value as a to the method, pass array to the method, and return the array from the method. Finally, let us see how we can clone the array. So cloning of an array. So cloning, when you clone a single dimensional, we can clone the array of single dimensional and two dimensional. Now let us see what is the difference with them. When you clone a single dimensional array, such as an object of square bracket, a deep copy is performed with the new array containing copies of original arrays. So that element opposes to the reference. So let us see, this is a pictorial representation of a single dimensional array. When you clone the int array to the cloned array, the new copy of array is created. That is called deep copy. So the reference will be different. So for example, let us see the example. Int array is equal to 1, 2, 3, and I'm just going to clone it by using a clone method. Int clone array is equal to int array dot clone of. So I'm cloning this int array into a new array. So this will create a deep copy. The deep copy means a separate new copy of array will be created. So the reference will be different. That's why when you compare the two elements, int array is equal double equal to of clone array, if you compare to the two array, it returns a false value because the new reference has been created for the cloned. So here you can see the output when you print the comparison between these two cloned original array and with the cloned array, that it will returns a false because it is creating a new reference. And you can print the new array by using a for loop statement. The output, the clone array is printed, 1, 2, 3 will be printed in the output. So this is the cloning of single dimensional array. So when you go for a multi-dimensional array, so when you create a cloning in a multi-dimensional array, it makes a shallow copy. Shallow copy means the main array will be created separately, but subarrays will be shared there data. So let us see an example. Here is an int array is my original array, and if you cloned with a clone clone method, a new clone array, the variables will be, new array is created, but both the arrays are sharing the subarrays. So subarrays are shared with this two arrays. Let us see an example. So in this class, I have created a array int array with the values 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5. So this is a multi-dimensional array I have, and this is cloned by clone method in a new clone array of. So when you, as I said, when you create a cloning with a multi-dimensional array, it creates a new array, main array, and the reference are different, but your subarrays are shared. So when you compare the int array double equal to clone array of, if you compare, it returns a false statement because it is newly created. Your clone array will be creating a new reference. So the comparison will return a false. But as I said, in a shallow copy, the subarrays are shared. So when you compare the subarrays, for example, int array of 0, double equal to clone array of 0. When you compare the subarray of first array and second array, they will be returned true because they are all shared their memory. So this is the how multi-dimensional array will be cloned. So in single dimensional array, it makes a deep copy. In multi-dimensional array, it creates a shadow copy. Shallow copy. Okay. So this is the cloning of array. So I think you will be have a clear idea about an array. And let us see what are the things today we have seen in this video. So first we have seen an introduction about an array. What is an array and what is the difference between array used in Java whereas used in C and C++, and how to create initialize and accessing the array by using for loop, and also by using for each loop. And then we see an array of objects, how to create an array of objects for a user defined class. And then what is the multi-dimensional array and how multi-dimensional arrays are created and used. And then we see how to pass an array to the methods and how to returning an array from the methods. And finally, we have seen the cloning of array. At the cloning of array, we have one dimensional array cloning and two dimensional array cloning. So one dimensional array cloning will be doing the deep copy, whereas the multi-dimensional array cloning will do the shallow copy. So I think you are all clear with this idea. And for any queries, you can mail to umeshr@sedu.ac.in. And thank you.